Hi everybody, welcome back. Today, I am going to try out a couple of new makeup items that I got from Shu Uemura. I haven't bought any Shu Uemura items for years. I used to buy a few of their like blushes. I have the eyebrow pencil, but you know, it's been a long time since I actually ventured and explored the brand. But yeah, something caught my eye. I think I saw it on Instagram. Was it on Instagram or maybe on YouTube? This collaboration with, okay, I've already taken it out. This collaboration with Sadaharu Aoki Paris. So he is a chef in Paris. So he owns like a dessert place and he's really, really famous apparently. I have no idea who he is, but let me just take out what I got first. Start with the eyeshadow palette, and this is the Matcha. Oh my gosh, this is so bad pronunciation. Gnoise? I don't think it's pronounced that way. I will put the name here. It's an eye palette and it's inspired by one of the cakes. It's so clever because cakes are like soft. Even the palette is a little bit like spongy. And also, it's supposed to smell like matcha. And it does, very lightly, like hints of matcha smell. You know, when you bring green tea up close, you get this sort of sharp, slightly green, and oh my gosh, it smells like it. So this is the eyeshadow palette. I will obviously put a close-up. So pretty. So he came up with two eyeshadow palettes, this and one which is Azuki, so it's red bean inspired. That I am resisting because, you know, I just don't want to buy for the sake of buying. So I thought I'd get this one, and I do like these kind of shades. What really attracted me to this palette is the shimmer shades. There are 1, 2, 3, which is sort of dual chrome, like multicolor. I believe what they did was when they mixed the shimmer, instead of, you know, really mixing it in, so they got different colors, maybe like a silver, a brown, a bronze, a gold, instead of really mixing it until it changes color to, let's say, a light brown, they would just roughly stir it. So that's why you see this kind of like a cookie and cream, big chunks of the lighter color, which, you know, visually looks very appealing. But once you start to mix it up, I think you will get a softer green, a softer peach, a softer bronze color. I also picked up one lipstick in the pink range. Really love this kind of acrylic, you know, see-through packaging. I find it so modern and I don't know, it's just nice to look at. So the color that I picked up is Azuki Caramel. Oh my gosh, it does smell of caramel. It's so, so pretty. It is, okay, I'm gonna swatch it on my hand. It's a creamy formula. It's like a reddish caramel color. So pretty. I think this is one of the more flattering colors. There was one more shade, which was Mikan Ginger. I wanted to get that. It was like a burnt orange, but more orange, and yet it's not like bright orange. So I thought I might still consider getting that. I'm thinking about it. I also got a free little bag, so let me just show you. I always find them to be quite handy. Look at that, it's see-through. And it comes with another piece that she told me this is to keep your mask. Well, you could keep, like, you know, tickets or something that is flat. I kind of like this, you know, if you're traveling, I think this would come in handy for cash. Let me just tell you what I've got my face. I have foundation, I am using the Sisley Cushion. I also have a bit of blush, and I'm using the, this is limited edition blush, so, Sukyu's, what look like an orange blush to match this palette. And I've got powder on my face, which I'm using my Chantecaille. So I do have like a base on. I only don't have any eyeshadow, and I have a bit of lip balm before the lipstick. So I can't use all the colors. I'm just gonna go in with the base first, this cool tone color right here, which is M6. Kind of convenient to use alphabet numbers, right? All right, using the Sonia G Worker 2 brush, I'm gonna pick up a little bit. I'm looking down because I have a mirror in front of me. And then I'm gonna put that all over my eyelid. Wow, they blend so well. I forgot how amazing Shu Uemura's eyeshadows are. So the matte is blending like a dream. So this is a cool tone beige, really good as a base. If you're just a one eyeshadow person, like you don't need a palette, you can just get one of these eyeshadow colors, just a base to give a bit of, I guess, dimension on your eyelid. I'm going to go in with this orange color, which is M8. And I'm just going to take a little bit and I'm going to dust that on the inner part to the middle of my eye. Right. Ooh, that looks fun. Like just the inner part, like inner half of my eye. Immediately, that lightness comes through. And I'm just really tapping. Because I don't really want a super, super bright look. Next, I'm gonna go in with M9, which is a little bit more bronzy. So this is a shimmery shade. I'm gonna use the same brush again and same thing. Just a tap, and now I'm gonna focus that on the outer corner, so the outer half, tapping, and then blending it towards the middle. So it's starting to be a bit more shimmery. You know what? Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Let's redo it. Okay, hang on. We will fix that. There is no issue. So now I'm going to go, okay, taking the same brush. Instead of going with that bronze first, I'm going to take this orange, this top M5 color, and I'm going to put that on top of that glitter, which was actually a mistake. Okay, because what I want to do is get that bright, well, sort of like a brightness sunset rust color on the outside and then lay that golden brown on top. So I'm sort of almost like mixing it together already, which, you know, gives the same effect. Wow, it looks so glittery. So let me just brush my brush off a little bit. So using the same brush. So let's do the other side properly. So I'm gonna go outer corner first, tapping it like this. Okay. Yeah, that's better. And then going in with this M9 shade. Oh my gosh, I love the numbers now. Because they're so easy to remember. M1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, and then now I'm going to put that on top of that rust color M5. So you get the same effect, but this looks more blended. Whereas, of course, because I put the base with the rust and then I put that color on top, this side looks a little brighter. But honestly, you know, I can see it, but if you were just walking past, they'd probably look the same. I'm done with the lid, and actually I feel like to balance it off a little bit, I am going to do a little bit under for my under eye. I don't usually put color on my under eye because, I don't know, I don't think it looks nice, but I'm going to do it for this try on. So I'm taking a bit of that first shade, or M6, and I'm going to look down like this and just give a bit of color under my eye here, under my eyelashes. Do it on the same side. And going in with that orange shade a little bit, and I'm gonna do, so I'm sort of like duplicating the bottom, so I'm gonna put that on the inner to the outer middle. Okay, just a little bit. I don't need it to be precise. Okay, then I'm gonna go in that rust shade and focus it on the outer but bottom, like right here, just a little bit. So I think my eyes are done. If you want me to play with this palette again with another look, let me know in the comment section down below. I think that's done really fast. It would have been faster if I wasn't filming. I think it would take like super, I don't know, less than a minute. I'm gonna line my eyes, curl my eyelashes, put a little bit of mascara on, and I'll be right back. My eyes are done. Let me wipe off this balm. Now I'm gonna go in with the lipstick. Ah, man, I've been waiting to try this. I think this is going to be a beautiful color. Even the beauty advisor was saying that this is one of the, ooh, that is pretty. This is a beautiful, this is a beautiful color. It's really a mix of the Azuki red bean color with caramel, and this is the exact tone that you get. Can you see that glow? It's so hydrating. I feel like this is going to be one of those lipsticks that you will need to reapply if you're wearing a mask. Maybe it will, yeah, it definitely will transfer. However, let's do this test. Let's see the color that stays behind, you get a bit of that orangeness, right? It's still really pretty, okay? Yeah, there's that hint of color. So I think as it fades, you know, if you're not eating or you're just, you know, wearing your mask, you're just wiping your mouth, whatever, you can see that hint of the color that's left behind. Oh, that's pretty. Okay, that's really pretty. So let's put a little bit more back. You could even do like a stain with this lipstick, like dab a little bit in the middle, like those Korean makeup looks, you know, dab it in the center, right? And then pat it outwards, and it looks as if you've been like sucking on a lollipop or something, which is very young and youthful, I guess. But anyway, this is the finished look. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, make sure you subscribe, hit that notification bell as well. Otherwise, everybody, please take care, stay safe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!
Wow! This is a nice color.
I love it. I love this color. Oh my gosh. Okay, we definitely need to get one more.